Well, I'd like to talk to you.
The feeling is one-sided, I assure you.
Are you leaving?
You bet. My doctor told me I must never live in a swamp.
I don't know what you imagine you saw today.
I have no imagination. I know what I saw.
Well, for certain reasons, I'd rather Mr. Ames didn't know anything about it.
For certain reasons?
I make it worth your while to keep quiet about it.
You know, there's one thing I like about you. You never surprise me. You act just like I figured you the first day. Listen, if I want to talk, I talk, and if I choose to keep my mouth closed, it's closed.
Did you say anything?
No, but only for one reason. I like Mr. Ames. And knowing about you and Fancy Face would just about smash up his life.
Well, that's settled then.
Oh, no, don't go. I've only started. Dumb as you are, how can you look at Mr. Ames and then go off and meet little Hussey on the side?
I don't have to listen to this.
Oh, yes, you do, dearie. You're in a tough spot. I got you behind the eight ball, and boy, do I love it. I got to know your husband pretty well these last few weeks, and I'm here to tell you he's a prince. What could any woman want that he hasn't got? He's rich and good-looking and just a swell guy all the way through.
You sound so enthusiastic, I'm surprised you haven't tried to get Cliff for yourself.
Well, you think that's so crazy? If I was married to him, I'd get down on my knees every night and thank him up there for giving me such a break.
My, my.
And he'd be better off married to me, too. I'd be square with him, and I'd realize I was getting the world dished up to me in a silver plate and get value for what I got.
What are you trying to do? Change my life? Improve my character?
No. No, that wouldn't do any good. You're not kind enough or even smart enough to make Cliff Ames a good wife, ever.
And aren't you wasting your breath?
No, I'm having the time of my life. This is my lucky day. That long-legged slimmy boy's gonna marry me, and I'm getting a chance to tell you what I think of you. Boy, some fun.
I suppose you told your fiancé all about this afternoon.
Guess again.
Then how did you explain your leaving?
I told him I didn't like it here. Slim doesn't have to ask me questions because he knows I'm on the up and up with him. But I don't know how long I'll be able to hold my tongue. So do me a favor, will you? And go home.
Is that an order?
Why not? I'm in a swell spot to give orders. Oh, and this is a suggestion. Leave Ponyboy where the moths can get at him.